Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. Previously, we looked at some of the fundamental concepts and basics using ConnectFX Paint. Now let's start putting some of these tools into practice. Our first example is a typical cleanup job. You know the scenario. You have taken the perfect shot, only to be ruined by a couple of tourists. So I want to go from this to this. It's not too difficult since it's a static shot, but it requires a bit of work. You can follow along with this video by downloading the media. You will find the link in the YouTube description or type the link displayed in your internet browser. We are going to use ConnectFX Paint and then put it all together in the ConnectFX schematic. Let's begin. Select the horse guard clip in the sequence and choose the Effects button and add a ConnectFX. While we work, just switch the display to show frames instead of timecode. This will help when working out the clone and reveal offset frame in Paint. Hover over the node bin and press P to bring up the Paint node. Just drop the node into the existing branch and we can get started with the cleanup process. Double-click on the Paint node to bring up the controls. Scrolling through the time bar, we need to find the cleanest frame without any tourists. Frame 165 seems to be a good point with only a tiny bit of the tourist visible on the screen. To remove the tourists from this frame, we will use a different point in time from the same clip as a reveal source. With the Paint node selected, press Ctrl+N to add a new source input into the Paint node. Now connect the shot into the red front input of the Paint source node. Since there is no alpha for this, you don't need to connect anything into the blue input. You can see the shot is in the list, and you need to select it and turn the matte off in the pop-up menu to disregard any alpha. Now scrolling through the shot, the last frame gives us a clear section to reveal or clone from. So you need to slip the Paint source so that this last frame is available when painting on the 165th frame of the original clip. So we need to do some slip mathematics. Click on the slip box for the front input. In the calculator, you type the frame number for the reference frame. In this case, it is 270 because this is the last frame in the clip. Minus the current frame, which is 165. The 105 you get when you press enter is the frame difference in time for the source reference. Now change the paint mode from color to reveal. You can also size your brush on screen by pressing Q and dragging. You can also use Option Command to zoom and Control Command to pan the image. If you enable the reveal overlay, you can see the reveal source on top of the image and you can see that everything lines up. You can leave the reveal overlay on or you can turn it off while painting. Now just paint out the tourists from this frame. You might want to do this a few times to get it right. While we are here, you can also do a bit of cloning to tidy up the frame. Change the mode from reveal to clone. To set a clone reference, hold Ctrl+Shift and click on the area you would like to clone and click on the area you want to paint. Now you can quickly go through and remove some of the blemishes and bolts on the wall. Just spend a little bit more time cleaning up the image and now we have a useful clean frame. Now let's start combining the clean frame with the whole shot. First, we need to freeze this frame for the entire 270 frames in the sequence. To do this, you use a mux node. In the small node bin, drag out a mux node. Connect the output of the paint to the mux node. Double-click on the mux node to bring up its controls. Turn on the mux node and set the from and to range to 165. Before this frame, we need to repeat the first frame, and after this frame, we need to repeat the last frame. Since this is one frame, it will now be available over 270 frames. So now that we have our clean freeze frame and the original clip, we now need to create an alpha channel to isolate the areas with the tourists using masks. Hover over the node bin and press G to bring up the G-mask node. Drag it out of the node bin and drop it into the connection. Double-click on the G-mask node to bring up the menus. Hover over the result view and press F1 to bring up the front view and bring up the G-mask tools. Click Add and draw a mask over the left side of the image. A rectangular shape will be fine in this case. You can adjust the control points and tangents to match the shape. And you can also add a bit of feathering with the offset slider. Now we want to click Add again and draw a mask around the right of the image. You need to pay attention as to how you draw this mask because you want to keep the reflections in the sign as well as not intersect the horse's mouth. To finish, you can draw around the outer edge of the image and close the mask. Hover over the result view and press F4 to see the result. So basically, we now have our alpha channel to cut the areas out. Now let's combine everything together. Hover over the node bin and press B to bring up the blend and comp node. Drag the blend and comp node out of the node bin and place it in the ConnectFX schematic. Connect the mux node containing the clean freeze frame as the main red front input. Connect the G-mask output as the blue alpha channel for the clean frame. Finally, drag a connection from the original clip and connect it to the green background input of the blend and comp node. If you select the blend and comp node and drag the time bar, you can see how the tourists and blemishes are finally gone. One step to complete this comp, because we used a still frame, there is no grain movement in the areas we fixed. Now you might not notice it in this video, but you will notice it on an HD screen or bigger. So you need to regrain the sections that were fixed. Hover over the node bin and press R for regrain. Drag the regrain node out of the node bin and place it after the blend and comp node. Ensure that you connect the result and alpha from the blend and comp node into the regrain node. Double-click on the regrain node to bring up its controls. The regrain tools come with grain profiles, but since this was shot with a digital SLR, there isn't a real grain profile. So instead, we'll sample the grain. Click the result view to select it. Now hold Ctrl+Shift and draw a small rectangular box over a flat-colored area of the image. This will analyze the image and apply grain to the areas limited by the alpha. You can adjust it according to your liking. You have successfully extracted the unwanted out of the shot. You can exit ConnectFX and press Render to process the final result. If you would like to see the same challenge again, but using desktop paint instead of ConnectFX paint, please click the link now. More ConnectFX Paint videos will be posted soon, showing the workflows with paint. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.